full court pressure again here?
Yeah, you're going to absolutely pick up full court, but you got to know it's leaving you exposed on the backside because you're double teaming the inbounder, usually right here.
Bridges not a primary ball handler. They turn him over. So the full court pressure bears dividends, and Sacramento's still alive.
And that was all about defense, and Kevin Huerter just taking his time, making sure that Bridges gets comfortable, and then turns and just takes it right out of his hands and slams it down.
Anytime you can turn the defender, Katie, right?
Yes,
you got a run and jump situation. Fox turned his man, and there's the result. Huerter with the slam. Sacramento with 35.2 to go. Down by just three. And after the timeout, we probably expected Monty Williams and the Suns would advance. So now that changes the defensive look a little bit, right? You can't press for a four.
Yeah, it makes me wonder if there's a chance that he's going to come out, Mike Brown, in some kind of a different zone look, because I've talked to him about his zone defense. When he was in Golden State, he used triangle and twos, boxes and ones, and he had an extensive playbook in terms of defenses that he would use. Now, in this situation, do you feel comfortable with your team being able to go out there in something like that and throw something different at Devin Booker?
Yeah. 35 seconds to go. It'll be Phoenix Suns ball at midcourt. They'll advance it. Oh boy, what a great sequence for Sacramento to keep them alive and breathing. The Huerter bucket and the Monk free throws before that. Torrey Craig to trigger. Sideline out of bounds for Phoenix. Fox, Huerter, Barnes, Monk and Sabonis, Booker into the backcourt. Gonna play it straight up. They're shrinking the floor now, a late double. They take it out of Booker's hands. Craig, Booker to lead. Five on the shot clock, Booker gets it back. Drives, Bridges. Craig with the rebound, and Phoenix will get possession, and that might be it. Sacramento unable to finish off the defensive possession with the defensive rebound, the all-important defensive carom.
And there's a lot of things in play here. How many times this ball had changed size, but then it's getting shot from the corner, and you've had everyone in rotation trying to trap Book. So that leaves you shorthanded in a situation where the rebound is always going to go, well, more times than not, it's going to go long on that three.
What a night for Devin Booker. 44. Damian Lee hit some big shots, too, to help celebrate his son's birthday coming up. And Phoenix leading by five. Devin Booker, 17 of 28 from the field, 9 of 9 from the stripe, and that was the Kings' final timeout.
And he is everything that we've always known him to be. He's a scorer. But getting back to what I was talking about earlier, you know, with Chris Paul out and the changes that they've had to their roster, everything is built around him. And you have 44 points, but it takes you 28 shots and, you know, 9 trips to the free throw line to get it. They're asking him to do an awful lot.
Yeah, I mean, his minutes tonight, to underscore your point, he's played 41 minutes.
Yeah.
And has looked tireless in doing so. The inscrutable Devin Booker. Well, 6.8 to go. Kings basketball.
There definitely is still time to potentially tie this game and send it to overtime. You saw how quickly the Kings came back and were able to get a bucket, a quick steal, and they got, you know, a 4 or 5 point swing very, very quickly.
Running out of time, though, with just 6.8 to play. Need a lot of things to go your way at this point. Barnes. They tried to hit Huerter for the three. Barnes has to take the two, and that's going to be it. Williams and the Phoenix Suns vanquishing.